What's up guys, my name is George and this is SaaS Master. Today we're going to check out Octolooks Scrapes. So what Scrapes does is a WordPress plugin that's going to scrape from other sites into your WordPress site. Now that's pretty cool. Now there's a whole bunch of use cases. It's not just about grabbing content from other sites. You can also use it for your affiliates. So for example, if you're using Amazon affiliate, you can grab the sales sites posts and you can put it on your site with your affiliate link. Now before we head on over to the user dashboard, I want to show you some interesting things that are on their site. By the way, if you guys want to grab the link, head on over to the link in the description. All right, so interesting facts right here. I'm going to show you. There's a whole bunch of use cases. There's like news, live sports, currency. So you can grab like currency from other pages and put it on yours, blogs, social profiles, videos, articles, so on and so forth. All right, what else do we got? So we have the instant control with detailed dashboard, which is this right here. This is my dashboard right here. And with this, you can see you can wait until next run. You can edit, run, copy, and trash. So those are the instant control detailed dashboard. Then you got support all WordPress fields. This is really important because everything's gonna be neat and uniform on your WordPress site. It's not just about grabbing the content and just putting it there. You can set the taxonomies, excerpts, author, discussion, date, images, status, and a whole bunch of things. There's a visual selector. So depending on the content that you wanna grab, you can use the visual selector. There's also the auto detect. My recommendation is that you first use auto detect, and if it doesn't work, use the visual selector. Next thing is the RSS aggregator plugin. So if you find an RSS feed that's interesting, you can grab that link and use it, and it'll grab the content from there. There's the templates. You can create your own templates. So for example, if it's a little bit more complex site, or if you want to grab more information and more precise, you can use templates and create it. You can set the title, content, custom text, sales, price, normal price, Black Friday price, or whatever. You can set it with templates. Find and replace. This is really good, for example, for the affiliate system that I told you. You can replace the links and put your own link to use it as an affiliate link. Or for example, if you want to remove the branding from site that you want to grab the information, you can replace that with your information that you want, or you can just remove it, depends what you want to do. There's also math calculation. I haven't tested it, but I think it's pretty cool. You can do rules right here, calculation, price, plus five, you can add or remove right there. Language translation. Now this I used, it's really cool because for example, I have some sites that aren't in Spanish. So what I can do is I grab the content in English, Russian, whatever, and I translate it to Spanish. There's a content spinner. So if you don't want to post the content as it is, you can spin it. Filters. Filters is one of my favorite tools because it lets you create filters for a whole bunch of things. So for example, you can, it's kind of hard to explain, but once we get over there, I'll show you what that is. And those are the interesting facts. Oh, WordPress for the WooCommerce. So WooCommerce, you can see that it also grabs a product type, product URL, features, gallery, stock, SKU, sales price. So you can grab those and put it right into WooCommerce. And there's some tutorials that you can check out straight from here. So you can grab videos from YouTube, which I've used already. I grab my own videos from my channel and I post it on my site. All right, let's head on over to the dashboard. And the first thing that you're gonna do is install the WordPress plugins. Easy and straightforward. Head on over to plugins, add new, and install it. Once you install it, head on over to settings and put your license. On the license thing, it's license per site, but in this site you can do as many scrapes as you want and as many sites as you want, so there's no limitation. So you just one domain, but you can scrape as much as you want. All right, so let's add a brand new one, and the first thing that we're gonna see is set the name. So you can set anything you want. In this case, we're just gonna say testing because it's not gonna be a real one. And we have three task types. So there's the single one, which means, you know what, I searched around, I like this page, or I searched on Amazon and I like this product that I want to promote. So that's one single page. And if you want to do serial, so for example, you head on over to Amazon and you search for cameras and you want to scrape anything that has to do with cameras, you use the serial. And if there's a brand new post, it's going to grab it. Next thing is the feed. So if you have an RSS feed that you found and you like the content from there, you grab the feed and you put it. Easy and straightforward. In this case, we're going to test serial. We're going to do this right now. And I haven't used cookies, but what I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, I'll correct it in the description. Cookies means that Scrapes has to go to the site and actually grab the content. So sites use cookies. So you can set your own custom cookie. So when it goes over there, it shows this custom cookie. All right. Source URL, the most important part. Where do you want to grab the information from? In this case, I'm going to grab this information from this blog right here. I'm going to put the link right here. And first thing it's going to ask for us is to select the post item. So where is the item that it's going to grab? And it's going to open the visual selector. Wait for it to load, and it's gonna load up that site, and I'm gonna grab the first post right here. So I'm gonna grab the title from this post right here, and next thing that it's gonna ask is that I select the next page. Now this is new for me. I didn't know they had this. I think it's pretty cool. You had to visually select the button that says next, but in this case it found it automatically, so that's pretty cool. If not, use the visual selector and find that next button. Straight easy and straightforward. If that doesn't work, use the enter URL parameter. Next is taxonomy. So what is this post type? So you can use the field used for post type for this post. Select that, you got all these options available. In this case, it's gonna be a post. It's not gonna be a product, it's gonna be a post. Create categories, so you can select by taxonomy. So categories, I'm gonna use the visual selector. And if this site has categories, so if I go all the way down, this one doesn't have the categories listed, so I'll grab it from here. So it's gonna grab that category. And they're gonna be separated by commas. So if there's several categories, it's gonna separate them. Next thing is the categories right here. These categories are the categories from my WordPress site. If your category is not here, go ahead and create it and select it. In this case, I'll use uncategorized because I'm gonna delete this when I'm finished doing the video because it's not a real one, it's just for testing purpose. But like I said, if it's not here, go create it and start again and you'll find your category there. All right, title, where is the title? So let's use the visual selector and this is the title of this post. You can enable a template if you want. You can find and replace rules for this title. And what would this do? Like, let's just say, for example, let me go back to here right here. So this title says 2019, all right? So the replace rule, it would find 2019 and it'll replace it by 2020, right? This is just an example. I'll just delete it. But just, I want to show you really quick what that was. Remove the find and replace. Content, so you can enable the template. You can enable find and replace rules also in this case. So if you want to replace a link with yours, or a word with yours, or the whole many things that you want to do, it can detect automatically, like I recommended before. Do automatically, test it out, run it, and if it works, it found the content, cool. If not, use the source. So in this case, source, you got the visual selector, and I'm gonna get the whole content right here. So you can grab sections, or you can grab the whole thing. In this case, I'll grab the whole thing. You can allow HTML tags or remove them. Download image to your media library. Now, this what it does, it downloads the images to your WordPress site that your WordPress hosting. If not, it's gonna use the link to over there. Generate from content, so you excerpts, or select from source. Tags, you can select the tags right here. Value, I'll use this tag right there. You can select from source, enter custom if you want. Featured image. Now you can see it also found it automatically. That's pretty cool. If not, you can select the visual selector and find the image that you want. But since it found it, we're gonna leave it like that. You can enable templates also, enable find and replace rules, or select from source, select from media library. So if you wanna set like a default picture for all the posts from this run, then you select from library. Then you have the custom fields. So in custom fields, you get a little bit more advanced. Remember I told you can use like the Amazon and replace it with yours? Well, these are gonna be values that you can use. Or if you're gonna use for WooCommerce or you have some extra fields over here, let's just say you're using some template from a theme or you have a classified ads and you wanna grab it from there, then you set those fields to those specific sites, to those specific sections. Customize, you can translate. Translate is pretty cool because you can select the source language that you know what it is and target language. So it'll automatically translate it. So let's just say you're grabbing from English and you translate it to Spanish, to Russian, to Portuguese, to whatever you want. I'm gonna disable that. You can spin fields. So if you wanna grab the content, but you don't wanna grab it as it is, you can use a spinner and what it'll do, it'll change keywords, but try to say the same thing and it'll spin it. Next thing is the publish options. So who is going to be the author? In this case, I haven't added authors, so the only one is admin. But if I had, I would have a list right here of the authors that I would have available. Status, is it gonna publish automatically once it scrapes? Is it gonna hit a draft, pending review, or private? In this case, it's gonna be pending review because I am going to delete it. This is gonna be testing. Date, do you wanna use the date that when it's processed? So that means if I do it today, it's gonna put the today's date. Do you wanna select it from the source? If I select from source, I click on Visual Selector, find the date, and it's gonna grab the source's date every single time that it scrapes. Or you can use Enter Custom. All those options. I'll use process time. Discussion, allow comments or not. So if your blog WordPress site has comments available, you can add, you can remove them or keep them. I'll remove them. Filters, unique post check. Now if it's gonna, where's it gonna see if it's unique or not? Why we want this? Because we don't want it repeating the same post. So title I think is the best option, but you can use content or from source URL. On existing post, skip to next process or update process. Complete run on loop. So that means once it loops, it's over and done. If not, it's gonna keep searching for new content. Filters, you can add filters right here. Filters are really, really awesome. Maybe you've heard of if then, then that. So if it does this, it's gonna do that. That is what this does. So for example, if it contains, or if exists, or if not exists, then do this or create this. So those are if then and do and then that. Next thing is schedule, cron type, WordPress by default, total post, unlimited post, total runs, it's just gonna keep running, total runs, or you can set, you know what, it's gonna run two times. Or total post, it's gonna run two times. Is it gonna first run? Are we gonna run it once we save this, it's gonna start immediately, or are we gonna schedule it? Run frequency, you can set it to every day, every 5 minutes, 45 minutes, or month, week, or whatever you want. So depending on how frequently this page updates, it's gonna search. So for example, if you're doing Amazon affiliate, man, that thing is like, I don't know, they're creating like 10, 15 posts a day. So maybe you wanna put it every hour, every 2 hours. Uncompleted run, terminate previous run, wait until previous run is completed. Run type, start from the first list page, or continue from last script list page. Then we have the other options, which is timeout for process, 60 seconds. Wait for next process, 3 seconds. I think that is too low. I would say 60 seconds. On error, you can skip to the next process or complete run. So that means on error, it's just gonna jump to the next one. Or are we gonna stop it? So it's gonna complete the run. Once all that is set up, you're good to go and you save it and you start doing tests. Once you, I'm not gonna run it, but what it does, let me head over to scrapes. All right here on my scrapes, you can run it, you can edit, you can copy or trash it. So if I run it, it's gonna refresh and it's gonna start preparing and it's gonna run. That's what it's gonna do. And once you've run it, you head on over here to your posts because that's where I set it. And you're gonna see right here. So I got these pending because I don't want it to auto-publish. I wanna check it before it publishes. So it just depends what you wanna do. I'll remove that. But what it does, I'm gonna open it, and you're gonna see that all the information is filled out. So I have the title, I have the information here. You can see all that right there. I got the images. This is actually the video from there, so it actually grabbed that link. And it just fills out all the information. And if you like how it looks, just set it automatically. If not, then tweak it a bit and then publish it. So it's a pretty cool tool with so many use cases. You can, like for example, grab the videos from your channel and start posting them every time that you post a video. Post it on your WordPress, you can grab from Twitter, AliExpress, Flickr, Facebook, Amazon, a lot of things that you can do. It's a great plugin, I recommend it. I've used it for years and it's worked fantastic. I set it up and once it's set up, like I like it, it's done. I don't have to do anything more. The only thing that would change is when a site does an update of how their interface looks or feels, then I have to update it. But if not, I mean, you can just leave it there for years and it'll just do it. Like you set it automatically and it will do everything. So that's pretty cool. Remember, this is Octolooks Scrapes. If you guys wanna grab the deal that's going on, check out the link in the description. Thank you guys for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.